get ready to match the stars from Vegas, Bart Braverman. Brett Summers from Mad, Gary Murdoch. Elaine Joyce. Bill Daly. And Marcia Wallace as we play the star-studded Big Bunny Match Game 79. And now, here's the star of Match Game 79, Gene Rayburn.
Okay. You're a very good bunch. Look at the legs on that guy in the first row. Holy mackerel. It's very
that's
distracting.
Not a guy.
Put
that's
him in
a girl.
Oh, is it? Oh. Hey, what does this mean?
By
at the beginning when there he said, Bart Braverman, you went like that.
I just made it up. I don't know.
Really? That's
of, you know,
the thing.
I fractured mean... piece. I don't know, you know.
Whatever.
It used
that.
To be in the 60s, and now it's kind of.
That's Charles Nelson Berghoff.
No, it's right. Not. But Charles left his tobacco here, I want you to know. I've got a tobacco store here. It's little bits of tobacco all over everything.
We want this all
if I sneeze
vacuum.
A few times
clean.
After the show.
All right, we'll paint it and fix it up. While Charles is away, he's in New York directing a play. Let's say hello to Essie Paul and Susie Coker. Current check of $1,400. Right?
Right.
How do you feel today?
Terrific.
Good. How do you feel, Susie?
Good, good.
All right, shall we continue here? All right, now, Susie, you had your first round question. You did not match any of our stars. Let's see how Essie Paul does with her first round question. Here it is. Harry said...
Oh, we've started.
I think my barber used to work in a grocery store.
Uh-huh.
Instead of shaving cream, he tried to shave me with blank.
How you doing, Bill? Just put down Ty Cobb like you did last week.
Essie, Harry said, I think my barber used to work in a grocery store. Instead of shaving cream, he tried to shave me with blank.
Whipped cream.
Well, certainly. Now, is that hard, Bart? What looks like shaving cream?
I'm sure that was a great answer. I just thought grocery store, and I thought there's so many things in a grocery store to choose from, and I chose the wrong one, so you can just pass on. I won't even tell you what it is, because it's really not important.
So come on.
I just said soap. It's a major series, soap. So I just thought, you know, Italian expression for all of you, but I won't tell you what it is.
Faccia la finestra.
It's very similar to that.
Who's kicksters, no,
that just means throw yourself out the window. That's all it means.
No, sweeter, I told you I'd save your blank if you'd just look over here and steal my answer, but I didn't see, I didn't know anybody even used whipped cream anymore. I just put Cool Whip.
Cool Whip, all right.
Oh, that's
amazing.
Hold on.
Now, wait a minute.
It's a substitute.
Cool
Whip is whipping cream.
It is.
Cool Whip is whipping cream.
Right.
Yeah. Now, hold on.
Get him.
Now, wait. Let's get the... we got to get a clean...
Yeah, can we get a
you
claim?
Say it's a non-dairy product?
Well, that's true.
So that's...
Oh, come on, now. Give it to him.
Hey,
come
on.
You're losing control
again. Well, all right, well, that straightened it out. I didn't understand it. I didn't know that Cool Whip was a non-dairy product.
She meant Cool Whip, didn't you, Hod?
Well, of course.
Okay.
Well, I said mayonnaise, but it's dairy. Oh.
It's what?
Mayonnaise is made from olive oil and eggs. Hello, Elaine.
It's dairy.
Barbara used to work in a grocery store. Instead of shaving cream, he tried to shave me with.
I said Cool Whip also. Cool Whip is just a chemicals. So, you know,
just chemicals,
it's not,
yeah.
It's not whipped cream, really.
Boy.
Well, we're in the 70s. Nobody uses whipping cream anymore because it's
I
too fat.
I use hand whipped
after
cream.
Hearing,
I don't use all that synthetic junk
fattening,
that's no good for
filling.
You.
After
for
shaving? After Cool Whip, I'm going to use whipped cream from
you. You use all that?
Okay, Bill.
He said Goya milk.
I would like a complete apology from the entire cast of this show. Whipping cream?
Say you're sorry.
My ear, that's why.
Say you're sorry.
But she didn't have to. She told it to me.
I told him to write
it. She told me to.
Oh, she gave you the whipping.
Why do I have to apologize? apologize for.
All right.
This show has really gotten violent since
No, it hasn't. You've gotten violent. There. Hello, Marcia.
Hello, Jane.
Hi, Marcia.
Be calm and
cool, Elaine.
And collected.
And what was your name again?
You remember me. We worked together once.
It was between this show and celebrity bowling. I think I made the wrong decision.
I thought this was celebrity bowling. I had a hard time getting
it. I'm visibly shaken that I've started off matching Bill Daly. Whipping cream.
Okay, two for you. Round two coming up. Right now, I got a message for you. Three, two, four, three, two, five. Top, front, front, so, boing, bing, boing, boing, bang, boom, boom, bang, bang. Susie, you want A or B?
I get a choice?
Yes.
I'll take A.
A. Susie wants A. Here we go with A. Ready for A? This is A. A will say, da 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 da. You're okay. Here it is, cut.
You've got to loosen up.
I've been very tense.
You can't appear bored on television.
Mean Marvin said, I just bought one of those die-hard batteries. I blanked it twice and it wouldn't die. Mean Marvin is speaking. Those are the operative words.
Mean
Marvin.
No.
One, two, three, all right, buddy, finish. Okay, Susie. Mean Marvin said, I just bought one of those die-hard batteries. I blanked it twice and it wouldn't die.
Shot it.
Shot it, certainly. She came up with what I think is the definitive answer. She shot the battery twice and it wouldn't die.
Is that what you think is the definitive answer?
I would think so.
You may well turn out to be right, but just to show that I have no preference for either of you, I've blown it for both of you, I put charged it twice.
You charge it.
You don't shoot batteries, you shoot. This odd job in another film.
You nearly cut his head off with that. Hello there.
You see the poor little devil, he's heavy into logic.
That's right.
Imagine a person who's
not on this show. No logic.
Doing I need good gravy, Marie L. Shot.
Shot. Okay. One for Susie.
The trouble with your logic is it's so illogical. You know, that's not the way to hurt a battery. You short it. I said short it.
Oh, you shorted it twice and it wouldn't die.
Stop.
Wait till you
listen, I'm half Italian, too. I got a couple of words.
I have a couple of words and I don't have a drop of Italian blood.
Is she finished?
Yes.
Okay.
Sorry, Elaine. Love the color of your hair.
I'll just stand by until you two cats have finished.
Oh.
I just bought one of those die-hard batteries. I blanked it twice and it wouldn't die.
I choked it.
Uh-huh. You choked a carburetor. But
charged
not a
doesn't
battery.
Look so dumb now, does
well,
it?
No.
Well, thank you.
You choked your choke, Gene.
No, you choked the carburetor.
What do you do
to a battery?
You shoot it
with a gun. We're waiting, Bill.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought... She whispered stab in my ear, which
Would
is very
you
good.
Stop I'm blaming of. Me for all this.
But I didn't say that. I said shot.
Oh. Uh-huh.
Well, sure.
That really is amazing. Everybody is implying with their answers and their colloquies that the dummy on the panel is Bill Daly.
Yeah, where did they get that idea?
Two out of two he's gotten so far. Let's hear it from Bill Daly.
He starts out by saying it's a bad answer, and then if it matches and he gets applause, he changes his tune. Shot.
Yay!
Two out of two.
I'm going to keep a score sheet.
Okay, now, where are we here? Scores 3-2 in favor of Susie. Essie, you need 1 to tie and 2 to win.
I'm gonna keep the score.
Fred said, this restaurant must be owned by a stripper.
Uh-oh.
I just ordered 2 fried eggs, and they came with blanks on them. You don't play? You don't play. Okay.
That's the only one I knew, really.
This restaurant must be owned by a stripper. I just ordered 2 fried eggs, and they came with blanks on them.
Bras.
Bras?
Yes, it is.
Really?
That was a good answer.
See, bras, do strippers wear bras? Have you ever seen a
stripper? They take them off.
Oh.
That's why they're called
strippers. Take it off, take it off. Try
all right.
In the rear.
You okay. Know that, Gene.
All right.
I think you'll find this to be the definitive answer. I think pasties will probably make
pasties. Pasties.
I guess that doesn't match bra, huh?
No, it does not match bra, but I think you're right. It is the definitive answer.
You bet your old-fashioned tintype pasties.
Okay.
She can be shocking without following through.
Right.
I said pasties.
Three pasties. Now, Essie, you've got to match Elaine to stay in the game and achieve a tie.
Oh.
Your eyes are so wide. Don't be nervous.
I said tassels.
Tassels. So that means Susie Colton wins the game. And come on down, Susie. Essie, how much have you got? $1,400. And our best wishes, Essie Paul. There she goes. Okay. Now, Susie, here it is. You've got $100, and you're very excited about that.
Oh.
I mean, she's calmed down a little bit, but she was jumping around here a moment ago, and she said to me, what'd you say to me?
I said I just wanted to win one game so my kids wouldn't think I was a jerk.
Well, you won it, and you've redeemed yourself in their eyes. Now, here we go. We polled the studio audience and said, write down your best answer to this.
Oh,
G
boy.
Blank. G blank. Now, if you match the answer that the studio audience wrote down most often, you get $500. For matching the second most popular response, $250. And then for the third, $100. Whom do you call on here?
Bill.
Bill?
Isn't that his name?
Bill, that's Bill. Idiot. I don't want to call on that idiot. Gee whiz.
Gee whiz. Yeah.
She has faith in him.
What is this crowd? This
they
is
love
my crowd.
You,
I can't believe they all hate me. This is the only crowd that ever liked me. This is neat.
Oh, I love you.
Oh, you love me. Thank you.
Joyce?
Yeah.
Elaine.
Elaine Joyce.
Married to Bobby Van.
Geography. No.
No.
G. Golly.
G. Golly.
G. Golly.
Listen.
That's what Phil told me.
G-Golly. Is that why you're going, they call on me, I got a good one.
No, because G-Golly. I wrote down Wiz and he took it.
All right, one more.
Marcia.
One of my favorite singing groups, the GBs.
The GBs. The Bee Gees. They're
that
wonderful.
That was just a joke.
No, what is your real answer?
My real answer. G. Willikers.
Yeah. G. Willikers. We got G. Wiz, G. Willikers, and G. Golly.
I
G. Golly.
I'm going to go with G. Wiz.
G. Wiz. Okay, that was Bill's answer. Let's see if G. Wiz is up there, and if so, where may we see the $100 number? G. G.
G.
G. G. G.
It's a Broadway show, a movie. Is it a horse?
Oh.
Horses are GGs? In what language?
In horse language.
Now, wait a minute. Are you kidding me? Does anybody, have anybody heard of that? Anybody here who goes to the racetrack? Yeah. All right, have you ever heard a horse referred to a GG? Oh, you say to him, GG. That's after you lose, GG. Really? All right, let's see what we've got on the next one. Please slide it. Here we go. G Golly Gumption.
I told you have a rural audience.
That's two things in a row I've never heard of. I never say golly gumption. I never said that as a kid or an adult or any time in my life. You want gee whiz, huh?
Yeah.
All right, let's give her gee whiz. Slide the big one. Picked up another $500, and we're gonna go on from there. But first, we gotta do a little business in America, all right? Okay. Susie here has just won the $500. That means at least she'll play for us 10 times that amount, or $5,000. But we want her to spin the wheel and see if she can double her money and play for $10,000 instead of $5,000. Good luck to you. We'll all root for a double. Here we go. All right, you're going to be playing with Marcia Wallace for $5,000. And good luck to you. If you're ready, Marcia, here it is. Fantasy blank. Fantasy blank. Okay, Susie, she's finished. Now, if you give us the answer that she's written on the card, we give you $5,000.
Fantasy Island.
She said Fantasy Island will match her for the $5,000. What do you say to that, Marcia?
What do I say?
Yes.
Fantasy Island.
Lady is very happy. She's got a bundle of money. She says, I'm so nervous, I don't want to play again. Now, let's find out who this lady is and where she's from.
I am a flight attendant for Major Airlines, based out of Los Angeles. I do a little volunteer work at a local hospital, and I enjoy sports. I play a little golf and racquetball.
Well, you're a very healthy-looking lady. Isn't she healthy-looking? Sun does wonderful things to your hair, too, doesn't it?
Yes, it does.
Yes. Okay, Deneen, good luck to you. You may have A or B.
I'll take B.
B it is. All right.
Hi.
Isn't this half-hour over yet?
No, it's half-hour not over yet.
He is Italian, isn't he?
The archaeologist said, this pyramid is a fake. It's the first time I ever saw a 5,000-year-old pyramid with a blank.
I got okay.
Don't say it out loud.
Yeah, this isn't the pyramid show, Bill. You can't say it out loud.
Yeah, I got you say one thing, and he's hearing, and he thought I said mummy. I didn't say mummy. All right, the archaeologist said, this pyramid is a fake. It's the first time I ever saw a 5,000-year-old pyramid with a...
stucco friend.
Go back to your other answer, Bill.
That was right. That was the answer to that question.
Stucco friend. Get your stucco friend out there.
That's not a definitive.
Okay, Bart.
There were a variety of choices, I think. There will not be a definitive answer. Don't feel bad. I personally put elevator.
Elevator's good.
Almost anything. Yeah.
Well, what we're after is anything that's incongruous with a structure 5,000 years old.
Speed up. Escalator stairs.
Very good. What do you got?
I said a stucco bathroom.
Stucco bathroom. Okay. Elaine, what do you got?
I said an air conditioner.
Air conditioner, very incongruous for a 5,000-year-old.
Aluminum, I can't say this word, aluminum awnings.
Aluminum awning, yes, sir. Very good. Marcia?
He's doing very well, isn't he?
Yes, he is. The medicine will help, though.
A den and or TV room.
Den or TV room, okay. Now, you stand by, Susie, for yours. Right now, we have this message for you. How much? 30 seconds.
Oh, we could do another show.
Yeah, let's do something.
Isn't it over?
What's a movie here? Are you making a movie?
Yes.
Is that why your hair looks funny?
I don't think it looks funny. I think it looks
good. No, it looks very chic, very different from your normal look.
Now, well, it's dairy. Get out of it.
No, I'm not going to get out of it. All right, I won't plug your movie.
You're not jealous, that lady.
What? No, tell us what movie you're doing.
No.
Okay. You got something? Oh, your hair looks funny, too.
She's doing the same movie.
She's got mayonnaise
on
her.
No, I'm doing a play at the Queen Mary, same time next year.
No kidding.
Hopefully we won't sail away during the middle. both Long Beach.
Okay. Look for Marsha Wallace and the Queen Mary. I'm Gene Rayburn. Join us next time for Match Game 79. Goodbye.
Welcome to the warm blanket of love that is George Gray.
Get out!
Got brain?
Goodbye, goodbye, goodbye!
New half hours of The Weakest Link, hosted by George Gray. Feel the love, coming up next on GSN.
GSN.
Get ready to match the stars from Vegas, Bart Braverman. Brett Summers from MASH, Gary Murdoch, Elaine Joyce, Bill Daly, and Marsha Wallace as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 79. And now, here's the star of Match Game 79, Gene Rayburn.
Okay. You're a very good bunch. Look at the legs on that guy in the first row. Holy mackerel. It's very
that's
distracting.
Not a guy.
Put
that's
him in
a
the
girl.
Hey, what does this mean?
By
at the beginning when they said Bart Braverman, you went like that.
I just made it up. I don't know.
Really? That's
of, you know,
the thing.
I fractured mean... piece. I don't know, you know.
Whatever.
It used
that.
To be in the 60s and now it's kind of
That's Charles Nelson Berghoff.
No, it's right. Not. But Charles left his tobacco here, I want you to know. I've got a tobacco store here. It's little bits of tobacco all over everything.
We want this all
if I sneeze
back
a few times
clean.
After the show.
All right, we'll paint it and fix it up. While Charles is away, he's in New York directing a play. Let's say hello to Essie Paul and Susie Coker. Current check of $1,400. Right?
Right.
How do you feel today?
Terrific.
Good. How do you feel, Susie?
Good, good.
All right, shall we continue here? All right, now, Susie, you had your first round question. You did not match any of our stars. Let's see how Essie Paul does with her first round question. Here it is. Harry said... I think my barber used to work in a grocery store.
Uh-huh.
Instead of shaving cream, he tried to shave me with blank.
How you doing, Bill? Just put down Ty Cobb like you did last week.
Bessie, Harry said, I think my barber used to work in a grocery store. Instead of shaving cream, he tried to shave me with blank.
Whipped cream.
Well, certainly. What looks like shaving cream?
I'm sure that was a great answer. I just thought grocery store, and I thought there's so many things in a grocery store to choose from, and I chose the wrong one, so you can just pass on. I won't even tell you what it is, because it's really not important.
So come on.
I just said soap. It's a major series, soap. So I just thought, I have an Italian expression for all of you, but I won't tell you what it is.
Faccia la finestra.
Very similar to that.
Who's kicksters, no,
that just means throw yourself out the window. That's all it means.
No, sweeter, I told you I'd save your blank if you'd just look over here and steal my answer, but I didn't see, I didn't know anybody even used whipped cream anymore. I just put Cool Whip.
Cool Whip, all right.
Well, that's all. It's in the thing.
Now, wait a minute.
It's a substitute.
Now, see, I'm
cool
not...
Cool Whip is whipping cream.
It is.
Cool Whip is whipping cream.
Right.
We got to get a clean.
Yeah, can we get a
you
clean?
Say it's a non-dairy product?
Well, that's true.
So that's.
Oh, come on now. Give it to them. Oh,
hey, come on. Hey,
wait a minute.
Get that producer over here. Get him over here. Come on.
Now, stick around here. Sit down.
It's too violent. This show's
you're losing bad. Control
of the
violence. All right, well, that straightened it out. I didn't understand it. I didn't know that Cool Whip was a non-dairy product.
She meant Cool Whip, didn't you, Hod?
Well, of course.
Okay.
Well, I said mayonnaise, but it's dairy. Oh.
It's what?
Mayonnaise is made from olive oil and eggs. Hello, Elaine.
It's dairy.
Barbara used to work in a grocery store. Instead of shaving cream, he tried to shave me with.
I said Cool Whip also. Cool Whip is just a chemicals. You know,
just chemicals,
it's not,
yeah.
It's not whipped cream, really.
Boy.
Well, we're in the 70s. Nobody uses whipping cream anymore because it's
I
too fat.
I use hand whipped cream. I don't use all that synthetic junk that's no good for you.
After for shaving? After Cool Whip, I'm going to use whipped cream for
you. You use all that?
Okay, Bill.
He said Goya milk.
I would like a complete apology from the entire cast of this show, Whipping Cream.
Say you're sorry.
My ear, that's why.
Say you're sorry.
But she didn't have to. She told it to me.
I told him to write
it. She told
me
to.
Oh, she gave you the whipping.
What do I have to apologize for?
All right.
This show has really gotten violent.
She came up with what I think is the definitive answer. She shot the battery twice and it wouldn't die.
Is that what you think is the definitive answer?
I would think so.
You may well turn out to be right, but just to show that I have no preference for either of you, I've blown it for both of you, I put charged it twice.
You charge it.
You don't shoot batteries, you shoot. This odd job in another film.
You nearly cut his head off with that.
Hello there.
You see the poor little devil, he's heavy into logic.
That's right.
Imagine a person who is
logical. Not on this show. No logic.
Doing I Need Good Gravy, Marie L. Schott.
Schott. Okay. One for Susie.
The trouble with your logic is it's so illogical. You know, that's not the way to hurt a battery. You short it. I said short it.
Oh, you shorted it twice and it wouldn't die.
Oh, stop.
Wait till you
listen, I'm lying. Half Italian, too. I got a couple of words.
I have a couple of words and I don't have a drop of Italian blood.
Is she finished?
Yes.
Okay.
Sorry, Elaine. Love the color of your hair.
I'll just stand by until you two cats have finished.
Oh.
I just bought one of those die-hard batteries. I blanked it twice and it wouldn't die.
I choked it.
Uh-huh. You choked a carburetor. But
charge
not a
doesn't
battery.
Look so dumb now, does
well,
it?
No.
Well, thank you.
You choke your choke, Gene.
You choke your choke.
You choke the carburetor.
What do you do to a battery?
You shoot it
with a gun.
Violence.
No,
it
hasn't. You've gotten violent. There. Hello, Marcia.
Hello, Jane.
Hi, Marcia.
Be calm and
Hello,
cool
Elaine.
And collected
and what was
now.
Your name again?
You remember me. We worked together once.
It was between this show and Celebrity Bowling. I think I made the wrong decision.
I thought this was Celebrity Bowling. I wonder
why
I had a hard time.
I'm visibly shaken that I've started off matching Bill Daly. Whipping cream.
Okay, two for you. Coming up right now, I got a message for you. 3, 2, 4, 3, 2, 5, 7, 7, front, front, so, boing, bing, boing, boing, bang, boing, boing,
boing, boing,
boing. Susie, you want A or B?
I get a choice?
Yes.
I'll take A.
A. Susie wants A. Here we go with A. Ready for A? This is A. A will say, da 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 da. You're okay. Here it is. Cut.
You've got to loosen up. Now, damn it, I told you.
I've been very tense.
You can't appear bored on television. Dude.
Mean Marvin said, I just bought one of those die-hard batteries. I blanked it twice and it wouldn't die. Mean Marvin is speaking. Those are the operative words.
Mean
Marvin.
Stand up.
No. 1, 2, 3, all right, everybody finished. Okay, Susie. Mean Marvin said, I just bought one of those die-hard batteries. I blanked it twice and it wouldn't die.
Shot it.
Shot it, certainly.